Hey, it's Justin from Transistor. Today I'm going to explain how dynamic ad insertion works for podcasts. A regular podcast episode, you upload an audio MP3 file, and it's just one continuous audio file. And in the old days, maybe you would have baked in ads in it, or you might want to announce an event that's coming up in the future. Well, in the past, if that's all baked into the MP3 file, if any of that changes, if you get a new sponsor, if you have a backlog of episodes that you want to, you know, put an announcement in, you couldn't do that. And dynamic audio insertion, what it does is it takes all of your past episodes, if you want, and all future episodes, and it automatically inserts what's called a pre-roll, so an audio clip that's inserted before the MP3 starts, a mid-roll, or multiple mid-rolls, which are clips that are inserted at various points in the middle of an episode, and then a post-roll, which is audio automatically inserted at the end of all your episodes. And the cool thing about dynamic audio insertion is you create the campaign and it automatically inserts those clips in all of your episodes. Here, let me show you how it works. So here in Transistor, we have a really simple dynamic ad insertion tool. I'm going to scroll down. Of course, you can have as many podcasts as you want on Transistor, but here's a podcast that I'm no longer creating new episodes for it, but it has a good backlog, 101 episodes, and as you can see, it's still getting lots of downloads. And so I don't want those episodes to just sit there. I want to be able to maybe advertise my company or give them an announcement or maybe even just give them an update on what's happened since the show aired. So I'm going to head over here to campaigns and I'm going to create my first campaign and I'm going to call this campaign Ad Transistor. So once I've created a campaign, I can go into this ad inventory section and I've already added some ads, but I'm going to create a new one here. And this one's going to be called Pre-roll Transistor. Over here on my desktop, I already have a pre-roll recorded. I'm going to upload that. Click create, and I can preview it right away. This is what it sounds like.
This is transistor.fm.
So this is going to play before every episode in this podcast. So I'm going to save those changes, and I'm going to add now a mid-roll. So we're going to call this mid-roll transistor, because it's for the transistor ad. And I will upload this MP3 here. Create the ad, and let's go back and now add a post-roll. So this will play at the end of every episode. And I'm going to upload this MP3. Create that. Now I can head back to my campaign section. So here's the transistor ad. And now I can select which pre-roll, mid-roll, and post-roll I want in this campaign. So we just uploaded those, right? We've got pre-roll transistor right here. We've got mid-roll right here, and I could add multiple mid-rolls if I wanted to. I'm only going to have one for this campaign. And I'm going to add post-roll for Transistor. Now, the other cool thing about how we do dynamic audio insertion is you can also do dynamic show notes insertion. What if you could automatically, for each sponsor or each announcement, also include text and links in your episode show notes? So down here, I'm going to put in this text and these links so that it gets automatically inserted in every episode in this campaign. So to make this campaign active, I'm going to click this toggle here, click save. And now if we look at the episodes page, you can see it's reprocessing all of the audio for every episode. So now every episode is automatically going to have a pre-roll and post-roll. And then I can also go in and add a mid-roll. Let me show you how that works. So here in the actual episode settings, I can go into add locations and you'll see I have a player here and I could click.
I had to learn a lot of things in the school box where this.
And I can choose the right spot, click this button here, and now I have an insertion point for the mid-roll. And if I click save, now this episode, when it's processed, will have that mid-roll ad right in this section. So pre-roll and post-roll, that's easy. That automatically gets assigned because it's just before and after each episode. But for mid-rolls, you have to manually choose your insertion point for each episode. And I'm going to go through and do that for each of these so that the ad plays in the middle of every episode. So now you can see the audio has been reprocessed. And if we were to listen to one of the episodes, this one.
This is transistor.fm.
You can now hear the pre-roll has automatically been inserted. And if we scroll down, the sponsor info has automatically been inserted in the show notes for every episode. And this is now live. If we go and play this episode in Overcast or Apple Podcasts or Spotify, eventually these changes all get propagated throughout all the players and folks will hear the new, whatever audio has been dynamically inserted. Now, of course, if I ever wanted to change campaigns, I could go over here and I could click a new campaign. And once I make this campaign active, it would replace all of the audio clips that were previously automatically inserted. Or if I wanted to, I could go into this campaign and I could disable it and it would return all of my episodes and audio files to their default state. Dynamic ad insertion, dynamic audio insertion campaigns can be incredibly effective, especially if you've been doing your podcast for a while, but also for new podcasts, because as you create new episodes, you can just get in the habit of putting in your mid-roll insertion points, and then they're going to be ready for any ad campaigns or announcements that you want to make in the future. A quick story, a really well-known author that I think a lot of folks would recognize was doing a launch campaign for his new book. And he did not have dynamic audio insertion. And so he had to pay somebody to download all 300 episodes, all 300 MP3 files, manually insert audio at the beginning, in the middle, and the end to announce his book launch, to let people know that it was coming. And after the launch was done, he had to get that same person to go back and re-upload all of his old episodes so that he would have the default audio again. You don't have to do it that way. You can use dynamic audio insertion and have it done automatically for you. If you'd like to try dynamic audio insertion out, try Transistor. You can get a free account for 14 days and even migrate your existing podcast. Try out dynamic audio insertion on your existing show. And then if you decide to switch, migrating is really easy. You just go back to your old host, forward your old feed to Transistor, and then you'll be publishing on us going forward. For more information, go to transistor.fm.